Praise the Lord, praise the Lord, praise the Lord. This is Pearly Marie Mosley. Some people don't even know that's my name, but I am a pearl today, and I got crowns in the studio with me. Welcome to From Glory to Glory with me, your glory lady, your host. Amen. It's good to be here today, and let me just share this with you. I'm always excited, but I'm double excited today. I got two people with me that have made me doubly excited on today, and they are my friends indeed, and many of you know them. Many of you have heard the legacy that they have left. You know about the legacy that they have right now in society all across this world. It is an honor. They don't even realize what an honor it is to have them in the studio, but I want you all to welcome with me today here at Holy Spirit Broadcast Network and CWWN Network. We're going to talk for the next 25 minutes. I'm going to let you hear the voice of Pastors Alfred Jr., we call him Al, yes, Pastor yes. Al, and Noel Craig Amen. Of I Am Ministries. God bless you
God
both
bless
for being
you. God
here.
Bless you. God bless you.
God bless you.
Amen. Amen.
Thank you.
Amen.
For having us.
It's yes, my yes. pleasure to have you because you know that I love your dad.
Yes.
You know, everybody's his daughter. He calls yeah. me a daughter too.
Okay.
And yes. he has spoken into my life. He has helped me in my life. He has the very first one to ever do our anniversary when we came here. And we'll okay. celebrate 20 years.
Wow.
And when he came in to do the anniversary, he left an impartation in that house that changed our whole mindsets about the economy in which we live in, mm-hmm. about finances and about money. Mm-hmm. And he is a man, amen, that God has used as a spiritual father across mm-hmm. this nation. Mm-hmm. Dr. Alfred amen. Craig, if you watch this, you hey. And Pastor Beverly, hey. We love you. And we thank yes. God for the both of you and Dr. Beth. Amen. So, amen. Pastors, I'm happy to have you here with me. And, I know what's on you. Amen. I know what you carry. So I know today we're going to talk a little bit about stepping out in faith.
Mm-hmm.
Well, that's all you know.
That's all we know. Faith.
I've seen you for the 20 years I've been here.
Mm-hmm.
And the enemy has never been able to steal your faith.
Amen.
Never Amen. In any realm, in anything. I don't know your personal lives, but I know my own. And I know within my life, I have had, since I've been pastoring, I have had many opportunities to think God has forgotten about me, left me, and never going to come back. Mm-hmm. But I have to walk in faith. Mm-hmm. So I want you all to tell me today, and I'm going to just kind of turn it over to you,
okay.
Pastor, and you and your wife can kind of share with the listening audience. If you're watching this on Facebook Live today, would you tag a few people and let them know, a lot of people, not a few, and let them know that we have the Craigs with us today, and they have something to say. They always do. Amen. And so I want to know, how long have you been seeing your pastors and of the I Am Church and the vision of the church, amen, what God has given you for the people. And mm-hmm. then just go ahead and talk a little bit about what you feel like. I see that you have a few notes, amen.
Amen.
And because, you know, they're school people, very educated, amen, mm-hmm. College people here.
Yes.
And I want you to just be at liberty to speak to the people today.
Okay.
Amen.
Well, we've been pastors for 2 years now.
Mm-hmm.
We took on the assignment of my father, Apostle Alfred Craig Senior, and also Ambassador Beverly Craig. We took on that assignment. At first, myself, I was very hesitant to take on that assignment because just being in ministry for the last 47 years, seen a lot of crazy going on. It's like, you know what? My brother did it. Let him go and do it. My mm-hmm. sister did it. Let her do it. But then God said, no, it's your time to go and step out.
My God.
And you can no longer wait. So I stepped out in that mm-hmm. 2 years ago. But then there was something in my spirit saying, you know what? I want you to really step out in faith mm-hmm. because no one was doing what God's called me to do, which mm-hmm. is have my wife along the side of me.
Hallelujah.
And I knew, for one thing, I knew the transition was about to happen when Apostle Craig, he said, you know what, he's leaving and he's going to put me out there. So I knew that was going to be a big transition mm-hmm. of ministry where it was like, okay, you transferring this part over to ministry, then we'd already know, you know, people who say they're going to be for you
uh-huh.
truly find out they really ain't for you.
Uh-huh.
And then all of a sudden, so it went from 400 to 500 members mm-hmm. from when I first took over to 150.
My God.
Then when me and my wife, because people didn't understand what God told me, is that, you know what, God says, you know what? No, let's have my wife on the side of me doing it because I wanted to show that a man and a woman can teach together.
And you got a queen.
And I got a queen.
She's beautiful. That who know,
and that who know who she is.
Amen.
And she's not intimidated by who she is either. Trust me, she's not intimidated.
She is
so
not.
I had to know that I had to step out on faith on that to really know that God really told me to mm-hmm. do this because mm-hmm. people are not going to accept a woman be on the pulpit.
Look at that.
And a side of her husband on top of that. Mm. So I had to know that, did God really tell me that? And I said, you know what? Whether I have go down to 10 people, I don't care. I'm going to do what God told me to do.
Hallelujah.
And sometimes when we say we're going to step out on faith, are you really stepping out on faith? Are you looking at the numbers or are you looking at the dollar bills
you
at the end of the day?
You better preach.
And I wasn't looking at it because I already know what God put in me. I know I can build.
Uh-huh.
I know I'm a builder. I seen Apostle Craig build.
Amen.
He can build. If he builds something, I was there when he had 10 members. And I seen when he had thousands of members. So I know what it's going to take to build. I know, and I know how to build. So I already knew what was inside of me. I just say, you know what? For the ones who are going to go ahead and do what you're going to do.
Do what you're going to do.
Do what you're going
to
do.
This is legacy. Mm-hmm. Amen. And to be connected to him, for him to be your blood. That's your blood.
Yeah, his blood, yes.
I mean, he got a lot, thousands of spiritual sons and daughters, mm-hmm. some who don't even give him the credit that's due him.
Oh, yes.
I know that.
Yes.
And so the legacy that he has already built, it speaks for itself.
Yes.
And all you really had to do is step in there because of that anointing and that impartation
mm-hmm.
and just begin to flow. Even if you just sat in the midst of them, which you all did, mm-hmm. you know, at times, because anything that God puts, he puts his hands to do. You know, I had a event some years ago, and I brought Robert Slayer into the valley,
okay.
and it was Dr. Alfred Craig who was having morning breakfasts and invited me to his breakfast. And do you know, it was kind of the first time that I had took on an assignment of that caliber,
wow.
if you know who Robert Slayer is, mm-hmm. amen. And I said, how am I going to do this, Dr. Craig? I don't even know. God just said, bring him. And he said, he'd come. And he said, don't worry about it. We're going to pray. And he had me to speak at that breakfast. And to my unbeknowing to me, I didn't ask him. I had no idea. Do you know that your father at that breakfast began to speak about what I was doing and the faith I had to step out and do it and took an offering for me? And before I left, I had $10,000 to cover the bill of that man coming.
Wow.
In. This
Amen.
Was years ago.
And that's what
that's
it is.
That's the heart of it. That's the legacy.
Mm-hmm.
He is. And that's on you guys.
And it's on us. And this is the awesome thing. As soon as I stepped into what God told me to do and applied my wife to assist me in ministry or for us to do, we call it doing ministry and life together.
Mm-hmm.
But we don't just do ministry. We
I
do
love
life
it.
Also.
I love that, it.
That's
I
our thing.
It.
We do ministry and life together. And so once God told me to do that, I had to now say, okay, what's the next step? And what we started doing, we said, you know what? We believe in God because I didn't want to go based on his faith.
That's right.
You better teach.
I didn't want to go based on his faith. I wanted to know that God told me this.
Mm.
So people, some people's like, are you going to teach what Dr. Craig said? Yeah, if that's what the legacy that he led me to do. Mm. Yes, I'm going to teach his messages.
Mm.
Well, I wouldn't teach his messages. Well, that's why you where you at. That's what you doing, what you doing.
You
I'm
going to
do
what's
the assignment of the house?
Mm-hmm.
And sometimes when we get into certain positions, people forget the assignment of the house.
My God.
The assignment of the house is to do what the apostle says of the house. So matter, and so what I done is I done that, and then I said, you know what, Apostle Craig, and he allowed me to flow in it. I said, you know what, the building that we're in right now, that's your faith. I don't believe that faith just yet, which is like that amount of building that he had.
Yes.
That wasn't my face. I said, you know what? I want to rebuild and restore what God told us to do as far as what I am is about now.
You so, all need to take notes mm-hmm. on this.
So
right
so
here.
What we did, we sat back and some people got upset talking about because we went to this one little building and they called it the weed church because every time we go into that building, it smelled like weed. So some people left the church. I'm like, Alfred and Noel, they don't know what they're doing. They don't know how they're doing it.
Mm-hmm.
So Ben, but then they would have stayed the course. If they would have stayed the course.
You better preach up in
if
here.
They would have stayed the course.
Some just mm-hmm. failed, y'all. Some fell
if,
up in
if,
here.
If they would have stayed the course, they would have known what God did.
Mm-hmm.
So within a year's time of me and Pastor Noel becoming in ministry,
mm-hmm.
we paid all the debt.
You,
our church is now debt free.
Hallelujah. Somebody need to tap on that. They are debt free. You don't even know this, but that's my thing. Stay for the conclusion of the matter.
Yes.
That is my thing. Mm-hmm. I say it at every event, every mm-hmm. service. Stay for the, you don't never know mm-hmm. what God going to do at mm-hmm. the conclusion mm-hmm. of the matter. Mm-hmm. You can't run out on them.
Yes.
Come on. So you're debt free now.
So we debt free. Within a year's time, I'm going to tell you what's really going on.
Mm-hmm.
This is the first year.
Jesus.
Within the first year of us taking over the ministry, we paid all the bills off. And on top of that, We give my dad 50% of the money.
Look at God.
We take care of him.
Ooh, I got shimmies on that.
We take care of him.
My God.
Amen.
And we got a month and a half in advance of payment on our rent. Then in April, when they talk about the what is that called? The pandemic, we went into another lease with another suite for our educational center. Guess what? With that, we've been paying on that educational center without even being to use it.
Amen.
Now you tell me that ain't God, and you can't operate like that without faith.
Yes.
You can't operate like that without believing, but you have to have enough common sense.
Common sense.
Common sense. Some folk don't get it. Mm-hmm. And they want to put you down and he want to go in this little building. Mm-hmm. And he got this big mega church his daddy then left him. Mm-hmm. But common sense told you that your daddy got faith.
Yeah.
I mean, he had so many churches in Africa. Uh-huh. I thought he could just move to Africa and live there. I mean, he has done so much in this nation, out of this nation, in the society, that the faith he walked, so he could walk on water probably.
Right.
You know, and you said, okay, Father, that is your faith.
Yes.
But I'm getting ready to go. Me and my wife, we're going to go on the level we're at now and watch God.
Watch God.
Build our faith.
Because we've been taught by the best.
You've been taught by the best.
So if you've been taught by the best, whatever happens, it's just a season. And you're going to go right back to that point.
I love it.
And so God, he had us go to that area. But now we're in a whole other facility. Mm-hmm. These people right now, they're taking care of almost everything. They just repaved the whole thing. They repainted. They've given us money to take care of their building. And they redid the whole air conditioning unit. They gave us a whole other suite where they took care of. They redid the whole inside of the other suite we have. Mm-hmm. So God is doing it. Then a second part of it is where we honor my dad. Mm-hmm. Every time him and my mom come here, we make sure we bless them. Mm-hmm. On top of giving them the 50% of our income from the church.
Uh-huh. You honor him.
We honor him.
Can you kind of explain to people? They don't understand. For some reason, I'll be celebrating 20 years in ministry this year.
Mm-hmm.
And I remember, as I told you, our second year anniversary, Dr. Craig was my speaker. And he immediately came in and he saw my office and he went out. He says, you all need to buy this woman and this man some office furniture.
Mm-hmm.
He said, that's a shame what they got in there.
Mm-hmm.
He said, in fact, we're going to do it right now. Mm-hmm. That's the kind of authority that he walks in.
Oh, yes.
That's the kind of heart he has for the people.
Oh, yes.
It wasn't going to be for his furniture. Uh-huh. It's going to be furniture for my office.
Mm-hmm.
He says, we're going to get them some nice stuff they deserve to have. And I just thought, wow.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and you know what? It was in the house, and I didn't know it.
It's in the house. It's always in the house.
It's always in the house.
It's always in the house.
And I didn't even know it.
Mm-hmm.
Wow. And so that is the honor he has bestowed. And so he has that honor coming back to you.
Oh, yes. A hundredfold.
A hundredfold.
And I told him one way or another, if no one else help him out, we're not going to ever forget.
Never.
My God.
How do they say, Jesus, you never forget?
Jesus, you never forget. What have you done for me?
For me?
So, Dr. Craig, I'm going to call you little doctor.
Yeah, amen. You go. Hey. I'm working on it. I'm working on it.
So what do you do?
What do you do, babe?
There with them.
I'm just there, you know.
No, you're not. You're not just there.
We do the same thing. You know what I'm saying? We're there. We're building the ministry. We do ministry and life together. We involve our membership with everything that we do. So
I love the ministry and life together. That is the revelation God gave you all.
Yes.
Amen.
Ministry and life.
Ministry and life together.
And more of us, you know, we'll give him the credit, but we need to pick that up, you know, especially the married couples.
Oh, yes.
Ministry and life together. Mm-hmm. Because this, you got to live.
Yep.
In ministry and out of ministry.
Yes.
You got to live and you have to have a life.
And you got to have a
outside
life.
Outside of that.
I learned that growing up.
Yeah.
I learned that growing up.
Yeah.
Where Apostle Craig always told us, you got to put your three P's in order.
Mm-hmm.
Your personal, your private, and your public. However you are in your personal and your private is going to be your overflow into your public life.
Look at that.
So if you ain't got them two in order, if you ain't got your home in order and your spouse in order, guess what? It's going to overflow into your public life. So I make sure I get those two in order.
Hallelujah. Some of you need to take
Amen.
Notes on the three P's.
Amen.
Amen. And make sure that it's in order.
Amen.
So I'm going to ask you this question about faith. Amen. The Bible talks about the just shall live by faith. You just kind of told me what you think that means. You actually are a testimony of that.
Amen.
Being justified by God, walking in the righteousness of God. Saying, look, this is what we're going to get. We're not even going to try to add up what it's going to cost and what we're going to have. And here you end up having favor on your life.
Amen.
Getting an air-conditioned unit, getting another building that you ain't even using yet.
Ain't even using it yet. But it's yours.
Mm-hmm. And paying debt-free.
Debt-free.
So what's the difference between faith and trust? Because y'all had to trust God for all of that. What's the difference? I mean, I don't know. We walk by faith, not by sight. And so we can't see what's going to happen, but we still have to trust God, don't we?
We do.
Amen.
They go hand in hand.
Oh, there we go.
You have to, if you don't trust God, you're not going to be able to have the kind of, okay,
radical
so
faith.
I have radical faith.
Amen,
like
she
me,
does.
I got radical faith.
I believe
the childlike radical
it.
Type
Woo!
Faith, and I trust God so much that I know that whatever I say, he's going to make sure, because I know I do what he said. I know I do what God says. Whatever he's telling me to say or do, that's exactly what I do. That's what we do together.
And we do it.
That's called obedience, y'all. Y'all don't know that's obedience.
I know that whatever we set our mind to, he's going to do it.
He's going to do it.
I already know he's going to be there. All I say is, like, this is what I always say. Faith is an action word. So in order, if you have faith, don't talk about it. Be about it. Get out there. Show everybody the faith that you have. You got to take a step. As soon as I take a step, I already know God has got it.
Amen.
Already know
already
he's going to guide the way the rest of the way.
That's that irrefutable faith. That's the faith that doesn't say it's loaded level.
Yes.
Don't say he might, he
oh,
could.
No. Oh, no.
It's a possibility.
No, he will.
It's
he
like
will.
He has done what
he
I
will.
Need him to do mm-hmm. when I step out to do it. That's
yes.
phenomenal,
that's right.
Pastor
yes.
Noel. That
yes.
is phenomenal.
Yes.
So faith, and then the Bible says, trust in the Lord with all of your heart and lean not to your own mm-hmm. understanding. And I believe that the Bible tells us that because so many times, the people that left, they were leaning to their own understanding.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
They were. Oh, they were. They're
yeah,
trying
they
to
were.
Sum it up and say, well, look, he already got this building. Why would he give it up? We already set. We already mm-hmm. look good. You know,
yeah.
we already leaning to their own understanding.
Or that favorite word where we couldn't stand. Well, we're not in excellence right now.
Oh, that's
oh
that's.
Well, what do you mean we're not in excellence? What do you mean?
So what is their definition of excellence, huh? Because I'm always in excellence.
Oh, yeah, we're always in excellence.
Mm-hmm. I'm always in excellence. Mm-hmm. No matter where you can put
doesn't
me.
Matter where
put
you
me
are.
On the side of the road.
Doesn't matter where
and
you
tell
are.
Me I'm going to fix it up,
oh, yeah.
and it's going to be excellent
yeah.
when I'm done with
when
it.
When I'm done
cause
with
it's a lifestyle. It's
a lifestyle.
It's a mindset. It's not what's around you. It's
that's
who
right.
you are.
It's who you are.
Mm-hmm.
That's powerful.
And knowing
yeah.
that.
Mm-hmm.
That's powerful. So when we trust, mm-hmm. we can say we have faith, but when we trust, we have to step out and allow it. See, when I people tell me that they have faith, and I say, okay, and mm-hmm. I did an example at the church. I said, come on up here. And I had one of the big six-footers come up and stand, big
mm-hmm.
guy.
Mm-hmm.
And then I had the little young lady come up. She was 10, but she was really tiny. I said, now I want you to fall back. And I had her stand on the mm-hmm. platform. He was down here. Just fall back in mm-hmm. his arms. And she said, oh, I said, you believe he'll catch you? She said, mm-hmm. I said, you sure? Mm-hmm. I said, just fall back in his arms.
Mm-hmm.
And she just fell back, and he
mm-hmm.
just caught her.
Mm-hmm.
Now, I had a grown-up come up there and do it,
mm-hmm.
and they were a little bit bigger than her,
mm-hmm.
but he would have caught him now because he was big
mm-hmm.
enough to do that. And they was like, I believe it. I said, okay, well, go back. She was like, I said, what you doing? I'm just making sure he there because
yeah.
uh-huh.
I said, you don't trust him? I trust him, but he might drop me. And
mm-hmm.
that's how we do in trust. You know,
yep,
we say
trust.
We have the faith.
Yeah.
She wouldn't just fall
mm-hmm.
back.
Mm-hmm.
And we trust. But we trust not
mm-hmm.
for real
mm-hmm.
in faith, because if she really had faith, she
would have just
back.
Did it.
Mm-hmm.
Exactly,
mm-hmm.
exactly.
Mm-hmm.
And that's what happens with our faith with God. We do the same thing with him. We say we have faith, and I believe God, and oh, yes, and God is this and that. But then as soon as you have to call him out, if you will.
The test comes.
You don't really have faith. Because if you have faith, you wouldn't falter. You wouldn't have a backup plan.
There's always going to be a test, isn't there?
Oh, always going to be
always
a test.
Always a test. There's always going to, when you're ready to go to your next step in your life, your next step in your destiny, your walk or your call in God, there's going to be a test.
The Bible
mm-hmm.
says that. It says
mm-hmm.
the trying of your faith worketh patience. That
it's
patience
has
a perfect work that you may hold entire, wanting nothing.
Mm-hmm.
So it's going to try your faith.
Mm-hmm.
Then it says, don't think
do
it's strange when you go through fiery trials,
mm-hmm.
as if something strange is happening, but rejoicing as much as you're partakers of the suffering of Christ. So
mm-hmm.
we're going to suffer during tests,
mm-hmm.
and we're going to have trials and tribulations.
Mm-hmm.
And so. Pastor Al, you said there's always going to be tests. Talk to me about that.
Well, I mean, I guess I live with Pastor Noel as
mm-hmm.
radical, and I live, and
mm-hmm.
I got the faith of Apostle Craig and Ambassador Beverly.
Mm-hmm.
I guess when people talk about tests, I never really experienced that test because I stepped out on faith. Another thing, I had a basketball career. I'm a basketball
That's
coach.
That's right, coach.
And
coach with us.
And I had opportunity to take some money 2 years ago and go out and pursue my career. But then I know what God told me to do.
Wow.
God said, what did I tell you? I'm going to sustain you and take
Ooh.
Care of you.
Amen.
And so what I've done, I said, you know what?
My
Let
God.
Me go and put basketball to the side
my
and really
God.
Do what ministry. Because everyone said they really wanted to do what God says, mm-hmm. but they look at the end of the day, they look at, okay, if I were to step out on God and do what God told me to do, what my finances are going to look like?
They don't have trust. They can't trust.
That means you don't trust God. Mm-hmm. Okay, what is this? What's going to happen with my family? What's going to happen with my bills? What's going to happen to my house? You know what? When I stepped out, you know, I still got the same house. I got the same car. We paid off mine and the well. We paid off all our debt. We paid off our debt. And we didn't even get a salary at the church.
Look at the Lord. You better hear what he's saying, because this is an example of irrefutable faith in action.
Uh-huh.
This is an example. Mm-hmm. And never in all of what you're saying, it's just the forefront of my mind that you continue to honor the legacy.
Yep,
the honor. One who yep. has put you in position and trusted you mm-hmm. to do what God, you couldn't do anything mm-hmm. but succeed.
And what happened too, people try to tell me to change the vision. Well, you know, you're the new pastors and you should do what God told you to do. No. The vision still stays the same. We can critique it. Moses had to, well, we're the new Joshua generation.
Come on. Mm-hmm.
So all we're doing is carrying out the original assignment.
That's right.
And we just, what do you call it? We're just amplifying the vision
what
now.
What a revelation. Right.
We're just amplifying the vision.
What a revelation that he just released in this place. With the Joshua generation, and when you are, Joshua didn't put down what Moses did.
No, no.
They would still been running around in the wilderness doing all kinds of crazy stuff. Hey, come on. But mm-hmm. Joshua took on the task to carry them in. See, God already knew.
Yeah.
He already knew Moses was going to be messed up. He already knew he wasn't going to get to go over.
Yeah.
You know, they didn't know that. And some of these people, they didn't know that. You might be watching now, mm-hmm. and you may be one of the ones that decided that, you know, they're not doing things right, and we're used to senior Dr. Craig and the way he did things. Mm-hmm. But I'm telling you, I hear the Lord saying, even now, prophetically, that some of those people need to return. And I'm not just using this as an opportunity to you know, point. I don't have a clue
right.
who was there, who left. I don't know the stories behind it. I know what I'm hearing now. And I know that God's hand is upon you, too.
Thank
His anointing is upon you,
Lord.
Too.
Praise
the
God.
Winds of change is blowing
Jesus.
Upon you all. And
Thank
I know that
Lord
what God
Jesus.
Has for you, it cannot be stopped. It
cannot.
Will not be stopped. It won't be stopped
nope.
because God's favor is upon
Lord,
you. And it's not
Jesus.
Just because you belong to Dr. Craig, but yet it is. Because
Amen.
Because he owes Dr. Craig. He's always going to take care of him.
Mm-hmm.
If you didn't take care of him, somebody else would.
Oh, yes.
He's always going to take care of him,
mm-hmm.
which means he's always going to take care of what belongs to
yes.
him.
Amen.
Amen.
And
Thank
so some
Lord
of
Jesus.
You are that are listening, you need to really check in with your Holy Ghost
mm-hmm.
and see if you're in the wrong place and you're supposed to be back where you started at,
Amen.
Where your foundation, where when you didn't have the money to pay your rent, gas for your car,
Jesus.
Food for your kids to eat, shoes on their feet,
mm-hmm.
you went to them and they helped you.
Or you got trained.
Now,
or you got trained.
and
you got trained and took it somewhere else and you ain't even giving back.
Good
right.
God Almighty.
Jesus.
How are you going to put something in somewhere else? Like that's like to me, it's like this. And me and Pastor Noel, we taught this.
Yeah.
Even for a church,
mm-hmm.
you planted in this church here,
mm-hmm.
but then you go plant your offering in another soil
Jesus.
Over here. Well, I'm gonna go plant my soil. I'm gonna go plant my seed over here. This new prophet coming to town.
Right.
But you ain't planting your seed where
right.
you getting fed at.
Right.
And then you wonder what's going on.
Mm-hmm.
Is that absolutely
yeah.
crazy?
See,
that
see.
Doesn't even make sense.
How you going to play? That's like you at your house, right? You at your house and I'm at my house. We next door neighbors. I'm not going to plant nothing in your house, in your side of the house. I'm going to plant it in my house. I want my seed to grow on my side
I'm
of the fence.
I'm going to pay your rent. And my rent is
yeah,
right.
And my rent is due. Come on
right.
now. I'm not going to pay your rent. I'm going to pay my rent in my house.
And trying mm-hmm. to figure out why things are not flowing and why things are not manifesting and why things are not happening.
Because they're chasing a word.
Come mm-hmm. on.
They're chasing a word.
You speaking truth.
Yeah.
You're chasing a word.
You're speaking truth.
Take care of your home. And after you take care of your home, then you go out.
That's right. That's biblical.
Go ahead, babe.
And I was going to say that chasing the word, that's something right there. That's don't even get me started on that because we don't have enough time for all of that today. But I'm saying, you know, a lot of times when you're just chasing a word, every word that you hear is not for you.
Not for you.
So when you running around trying to go all around chasing the word that's for another house, but you belong to another house, you can try to receive it all day long. But if the word was for a different house, it ain't for you.
It ain't for
you.
So
it's never going to manifest in your life.
And it won't stay down anyway.
Mm-hmm.
You're going to end up throwing up all over the place, regurgitating it up all over
Amen.
The place, eating too many different tables.
Too many
and
tables.
Wondering why you can't get it together, wondering why your mind is going crazy, wondering why during this pandemic now,
mm-hmm.
why you scared and you worrying so much about everything that's going on.
Because you're not rooted.
And you're losing everything.
You're not
the faith
rooted.
That you all are walking in.
You all
if they were with you, they couldn't help but be walking in faith.
Know it.
That's the mantle that's upon you.
Mm-hmm. Amen. Thank
you. That's the mandate that's upon your
Amen.
Life.
Thank
Dr.
you,
Craig
Lord
has
Jesus.
Said he has been a part of some of the greatest faith, fathers of faith that mm-hmm. we have ever known.
Amen.
I love the story he tells when he took that briefcase of money to Dr. Frederick Price.
Uh-huh.
Uh-huh, Price, mm-hmm. yeah. And has sown into so many lives. Mm-hmm. This is not enough time for these two. You all, you know
it's
that.
A lot. It's a lot. Yeah, it's a lot.
I love my 30-minute show. I might have to move it to a longer show because I'm telling you, I just would love to continue to talk to you. Pastor Noel, will you say a prayer? We only have 2 minutes left. Would you just pray for these people and just tell them when they're listening that walk in faith, not by sight. They need to go forward. You
Amen.
Go ahead and pray for us, please.
All right. So we always talk about walking by faith and not by sight. We quote that scripture all the time. So now we're just gonna receive it today.
Amen.
So Father, we thank you so much for the opportunity
thank
to talk
Lord.
About your word today, Hallelujah. To revive the faith in people's lives today.
Yes,
we want your faith, Lord, to come alive in people's mm-hmm. lives today. Please manifest the word in their lives the way that you can manifest the word. You can manifest everything that you have promised us in your word. We thank you so much that now even those who have not quite walked by faith, their faith may have wavered at some point or another. Lord, we thank you right now that you will wake it up in their spirits right now in the name of Jesus. You just wake up and you just grab that faith and you remember that dream. Wake up that dream inside of you right now in the name of Jesus. I say wake it on up right now. I tell you right now, if you wake it up and you walk by faith and you put some action to the words, you put some action to the faith and the word that God has released in your life, I assure you that they will manifest. It will manifest before this year. We're not in a pandemic right now in the name of Jesus. This is the time where God will manifest everything. If it's healing, if it's finances, if it's your mind, if it's whatever it is, if it's your family, if it's your children, whatever it is, whatever God promised you, it shall manifest in these times right now in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Woman of God, I was going to let you take us off the air. We get ready to go off the air. Thank you for tuning in to Glory from Glory.
Amen.
I could have had her pray a long time ago.
Amen.
You should have received that. That was an impartation coming from that prayer.
Jesus.
Thank you for tuning in to From Glory to Glory. I'm your glory lady, Apostle Marie Mosley. God bless you.
God bless you.
Amen.
And I kept opening up my eyes because she kept saying, make sure you watch me.